students. In your English grammar, as you all know nowadays, we are studying the first chapter, that is the sentences. I hope, my dear students, you all must have watched the previous video of the sentence in which I have told you about what is sentence, what are the different types of sentences, and after that I have taken your Google Meet too. So I hope you have understood all the different types of sentences well. So once again, let's review what is a sentence. What is a sentence? A sentence is a group of words which is arranged in such a manner that it makes a complete sense. Iska matlab sentence kya hota hai? Sentence ek shabdon ka samuh hota hai jo jise jod kar hum ek प्रॉपर वाक्य, एक प्रॉपर शुद्ध वाक्य बना सकते हैं. ओके, दैट इज नोन एज सेंटेंसेस. एंड आई हैव आल्सो टोल्ड यू दैट देयर आर टोटल फोर टाइप ऑफ सेंटेंसेस. व्हाट आर दोस फोर टाइप? फर्स्ट वन इज असर्टिव और डिक्लेरेटिव सेंटेंस, सेकंड वन इज इंट्रोगेटिव सेंटेंस, थर्ड वन इज इंपरेटिव सेंटेंस, एंड द लास्ट वन इज एक्सक्लेमेटरी सेंटेंस. So in assertive sentence, what I have told you, assertive sentences are the sentences which tells you about the facts. जो आपको facts के बारे में, तथ्य के बारे में बताएं, like the sun rises in the east, or declare or assert something that he dances, yeah, she dances. Okay. Something which we assert or state or declares. These type of sentences are known as assertive sentences. What are interrogative sentences? Interrogative sentences are the sentences which ask question and at the end of which question marks comes. Okay. Then the third type of sentence is imperative sentences, in which we order, we command, sometimes we request, we wish. So these all type of things where it happens, these type of sentences is known as imperative sentence. And the last one is exclamatory sentence, which states some sudden feeling of happiness, sadness, pain, joy, grief. So some sudden feeling or strong feeling occurs, that type of sentences are known as interrogative sentence. And at the end of these sentences, one exclamation mark is there, like one standing line, then add dot in the below it. Okay, so my dear students, today we will do one exercise related to this. In this, you can see I have on the board, I have written one exercise. What's there in this next week? So please, all of you, watch and understand this exercise very nicely. Okay? So state whether the following sentences are assertive, imperative, interrogative, or explanatory. That means what you have to do in this. You have to read the statement very nicely. Okay, after reading it, just think it over what definitions ma'am has told. Then after seeing the sentence, after thinking, just tell whether the statement is assertive, imperative, interrogative, or exclamatory sentence. Okay, so let's have a look. Let's enjoy this exercise. First one is at last. What's here? At last, we have lost him forever. It means he see this exclamation mark, can you recognize which type of sentence is this? Yes, my dear children. This is an exclamatory statement. Alas, we have lost him forever. So this is exclamatory.
You have saved the girl.
खुश होते हैं बहुत. एट दैट टाइम वी यूज द वर्ड हुर्रे देन ब्रावो. सो एट द टाइम ऑफ हैप्पीनेस वी यूज द टर्म ब्रावो. एंड दिस ब्रावो आफ्टर ब्रावो यू कैन सी दैट वन एक्सक्लेमेशन मार्क इज देयर. इट इज देयर ना. सो इट मींस दैट दिस इज एंड दिस इज आल्सो एन एक्सक्लेमेटरी sentence, okay? Because this is a certain feeling. This is a certain feeling. So this will be exclamatory sentence, okay? I hope, dear students, you have understood this exercise very well. And my dear students, same exercise I am giving you for homework also, but you have do that exercise in your book, not in your notebook, okay? Now, my dear students, coming towards the next exercise, your next exercise is place the correct punctuation mark in the boxes to make the correct sentences. So, in this, no punctuation mark is given to you. Boxes are given to you. You have to fill these boxes with the punctuation mark so that it can become the correct statement. Okay? And after that, you have to identify each sentence. What do you have to identify? Whether which type of sentence it is, whether it is declarative sentence, then interrogative sentence or imperative sentence or exclamatory sentence, okay? First you have to fill the punctuation mark, then after that you have to identify which type of sentence it is, okay? So let's have a look. Let's see the first sentence. Ghosh Bucks. Ghosh is our name of a child, okay? Ghosh, now you are coming. In this you can see that someone is asking question that to Ghosh, that Ghosh, are you coming? So after Ghosh, what we will put after Ghosh? Yes, my dear children, after Ghosh we will put comma. What we will put? Comma. Ghosh, comma, now you are coming. Now in this you can see that question has been asked. Question pucha gaya. So we will put question mark in this box. Ab is box mein kya laga denge? Question mark like this. Okay? Have you understood? Because question has been asked, so hum question mark laga denge. And I have told you that whenever there will be interrogative question mark, so it will be interrogative sentence. Okay, so we will write intro INTERROR interrogative sentence, SENTENCE. Okay, like this you have to write. Okay, now come to the second one. Wash your hands before every meal. Now, in this, we are stating that we have to wash our hands after every meal. Har meal ke baad hame apne kya karne chahiye? We must wash our hands. So that means we are stating. So which punctuation mark will come? Yes, of course, my dear children. Here, full stop will come. And whenever we are stating something or we are telling any fact, then that type of sentence is known as assertive sentence or declarative sentence. So we will write that this is a declarative statement. D-E-C-L-A, declarative sentence. Okay. Now coming towards the third one, in this you can see place. We are requesting in this cross the room. After please, what will come? What will come? After please, it will come comma. Please, comma, like this. Help the old man to cross the room. So, first step. So, in this, I told you, whenever we request someone, then it will be imperative sentence. So, what we will write over here? Imperative sentence. I am P E R A T I V E. Imperative sentence. Okay, like this. Now coming to the fourth one. How wonderful it is to be alive. How wonderful it is to be alive. That means very surprised we are saying how wonderful it is to be alive. When certain feeling comes, then at that time which mark, punctuation mark we use? Yes, my teacher. Of course, it's an exclamation mark. So we will also put exclamation mark over here. Hum yahan pe lagayenge exclamation mark. So which type of sentence it is? This is exclamatory sentence. Exclamatory, exclamatory sentence. Okay, like this, right? Now coming to the fifth one, Jack Angel went up the hill. Jack Angel went up the hill. So in this we are stating, we are telling. So what will come? Of course, my dear children, here first stop will come, and this will be your declarative statement. Declarative sentence. Okay. Now, come to the sixth one. Which dress did you buy for me? In this, you can see that in this statement, question has been asked. So, question puch gaya hai. Which dress did you buy for me? Aapne mere liye kaun si dress khareedi hai? So, if the question has been asked, so we will put question mark here. We will put question mark over here, and if the question has been asked, then we used to say that this is an interrogative sentence. So what's the spelling of interrogative? I N T E R O G A T I V E. Interrogative sentence. So I hope, my dear students, you all must have understood these two exercises very well. Practice at your home nicely, and if you have not understood anything, then you are most welcome for your queries, and you can make me a call anytime. So please do these exercises in your books. Okay, there is no need to write these exercises in your notebook, and that too in really neat and clean handwriting. Thank you, my dear students. This was for today. God bless you all.